Hello, I'm Saukki, and in this video I'm going to talk about what's the right crank length for your recumbent. Usually the easily available cranks are something like 170mm to 175mm long, and I think that also 165mm cranks are also pretty easily available. But what's the right crank length for you? That's something we are going to find out in this video. But first, let me introduce what kind of cranks do I have in my bikes. In the Quest, I have these 155mm cranks, and I got this from velomobile.nl. When I made an order for this bike, I just told them that I want 155mm long cranks. So these were already mounted when I got this bike. And then on the Azub here at the back, I have these custom-made cranks. These cranks has these extra mounting holes made by my friend, and I think the length of this crank now when the pedals are mounted here is something like 153mm or something like that. And these are custom made by one of my friends. He has the equipment to shorten cranks like this. But anyway, about the crank length, let's start with the science. I found two studies about the crank length effect to power output. And of course these are made with upright bicycles, but let's look at these studies anyway, and let's jump straight to the results. And by the way, if you want to read these studies, I leave the link in the video description, so go check these out if you are interested about these. And here we can see that both studies tested stupidly long 220mm cranks, and if we look the results from the both of the studies, we can see that if you start to shorten the cranks from this 220mm, the output power will slightly increase all the way until here, around 140mm. And then if the cranks are even shorter than that, you can't output as much power. And then from these studies we can learn that the optimal pedaling cadence will increase if you shorten the cranks. And we also learned that the optimal crank length is related to your leg length. And this other study actually claims that the optimal crank length is about 20% of your leg length, or about 41% of your tibia length. And actually I have a tape measure here, so let me measure my tibia. And this is about 43cm. And 41% of that is about 176mm. So apparently I should be riding 176mm long cranks for the best power output. But of course this data is for upright bike. And by the way, these studies claim that the standard 175mm crank length is actually good enough and a good compromise for most of the cyclists. And the difference in power output is only small compared to the optimal length. But these studies doesn't talk anything about ergonomical or aerodynamical benefits of shorter cranks. So shorter cranks might be better for your knees. And with shorter cranks, you can tune your riding position on upright bike so that you are much more aerodynamic, because you can bring your upper body lower, because your tights don't have to move so high. So even though you cannot output huge amount of more power, you can still be faster, because you can tune your riding position so that you are more aerodynamic. But then, what about recumbent bikes? The riding position is completely different, so I think that different rules apply to the crank length. But nevertheless, I think there are still ergonomical and aerodynamical benefits of using shorter cranks. With the right knee angle, your knee doesn't start to hurt, but you still can output good amount of power. And with shorter cranks, your knee doesn't rise so high when pedaling, so that will actually improve the aerodynamics. And with velomobiles, there's not so much space to start with, so, well, the benefits are obvious. But then, what is the right crank length for a recumbent? Let's look at this recumbent crank length calculator. I put the link to this in the video description. Here we can calculate the optimal crank length. And here's the instructions how to measure your leg. So let me measure my leg. Okay, so the A measurement, this one is 40cm, and the B measurement, this is, I think it's about 52cm. And okay, now let's calculate. And here I should choose the right crank length for me. And this calculator claims that the knee angle of 85 degrees should be the optimal. And for that angle, this claims that I should be using 145mm cranks. And from the earlier studies, we learned that with that length, I should be able to produce decent amount of power. But I'm actually using 155mm cranks, so maybe I should be trying shorter cranks. And then what you should know is that with shorter cranks, your optimal pedaling cadence will be higher, so you maybe have to use different gear ratios. And if you use shorter than 140mm cranks, then you need to have more gears to compensate the lack of maximum power output. Because at least according to those studies, your power output will decrease if you have two short cranks. But the gears are not the problem, because nowadays bikes have a lot of gears, and usually recumbents have also pretty large range of gears. But I think that back in the days it was more difficult when there was only one gear on your bike. Then you really needed to have long cranks if you want to climb big hills. By the way, crank length also affects this hip angle here. With the right hip angle you can output more power. But let's not get into that, because you can also change the hip angle by changing the angle of the seat. But then, where to get these short cranks? Well, that's a good question. These might be actually pretty difficult to find. If you are buying a new bike or velomobile, then you should ask for the manufacturer if they can get you short cranks. For example, as I told you already, velomobile.nl was able to get me this 155mm crank. And then it's also possible to shorten some of the cranks, like I have done here. Well, actually my friend. But nowadays, these cranks are usually some kind of hollow cranks, like actually this one is also hollow, so it might be a problem. And because these are this kind of hollow cranks, my friend has to glue this kind of bushing here to make this strong enough. But so far, this has been strong enough for me. But anyway, because I have no idea where to get these short cranks, I need to ask your help. Maybe there's someone who knows where we can find these short cranks. So, if you know where to find short cranks, please let me know in the comment section below. But okay, I think that's all for today. Please remember to subscribe to my channel and also click that bell icon so you get notification every time I post a new video. And then also visit my webshop and buy this kind of awesome t-shirts or something else. But okay, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.